On May 7, 1942, a massive attack launched from American carriers Lexington and Yorktown destroyed light carrier Shoho, the leader of a group of ships heading towards Port Moresby. When Shoho was destroyed, the remaining ships from the group turned north. The ships heading towards Port Moresby were also forced to retreat. Lexington and Yorktown continued their search for the Japanese fleet. Meanwhile, two Japanese carriers, Shokaku and Zuikaku, sailed around the Solomon Islands and headed towards Port Moresby. On the morning of May 8, the Americans detected the Japanese fleet and launched an airstrike from both carriers.
hasn't been damaged. Time to detect enemy forces. Looks like we've been given a break. Great. Wing, all land and fleet are good to refuel and reload.
Thank you.
everyone. I hope our bombers made it hot for them.
Oh man, I'm so relieved, as that was so hard dogfighting Maces like that. I hope you enjoy, guys. See you in the next one.
Believed to be the Zuikaku class, was observed by all pilots to burn fiercely in a manner obviously beyond control. Several severe explosions, other than those resulting from bomb or torpedo hits, were observed. And before the attack was completed, the ship was almost entirely hidden by smoke and flame. The smoke cleared before all the Lexington planes left the area, and the ship had disappeared. Report of Air Operations Officer, USS Lexington.
The Battle of the Coral Sea became the first serious test for the Japanese aircraft carrier Navy, as it was the case when Japanese aircraft carriers met American ones. And the Japanese undoubtedly called this battle their victory. They considered two aircraft carriers of the enemy to be probably destroyed. However, after the attack, the covering forces had too little planes left, so they had to postpone the landing on Port Moresby itself for an uncertain period of time. However, Tulagi Island was occupied, which strengthened the position of the Japanese on the Solomon Islands. The seizure of Port Moresby was considered an army operation, and the Navy was preparing another operation at the same time aimed at luring and destroying the rest of the American aircraft carriers. Now, after the Battle of the Coral Sea, the Americans were likely to have fewer aircraft carriers left, which made fulfillment of this task easier. Seizure of a military base on the Midway Atoll was to become a bait for the Americans. The Japanese reckoned that the enemy could not allow the loss of this strategic point and would surely answer the challenge, where there would be an armada of aircraft carriers and battleships waiting for the enemy. At the same time, the Navy was conducting an operation of landing on the Aleutian Islands, which were to become another pivot in the war against the Allies, which Japan was waging on many fronts simultaneously. In early June 1942, a huge Japanese fleet comprising over 70 ships and four aircraft carriers, Hiryu, Kaga, Soryu, Akagi, moved out towards the Midway Atoll.